So here we are, we're heading over to the waterfront. Just don't want to run over this person. Okay. There we go. I actually come here at night a lot to think about the world and think about life and, So this is a place where the community likes to gather, and, you couldn't tell from this shot right here, but, But in the distance, if you can see the Bayway refinery, I don't have a zoom on this thing. My friend actually works at the Bayway refinery. He just decided that was what he wanted to do. I'll show you the beach in a minute. I don't know if you can see it, but there's people kind of hanging out. You wouldn't imagine that there's a refinery. right next door to all this stuff. And I don't think a lot of people in the community really mind, and this kind of bothers me. So this is the beach at Woodbridge, and, well, Sewaren, I should say. They actually managed to clear out a lot of this because I was here a few months ago, and it had a lot more garbage, believe it or not, than what's here right now. Are you guys from here, first of all?
Yeah.
What are your names?
Mike.
What's your name? Purvis?
Curtis.
Okay, hi. Sorry, I can't hear anything. But I was just wondering, you guys are from here. You're from Sewaren or from Woodbridge?
Port Reading.
Okay, so Port Reading. Just a question. Do you think that it would be at all possible to clean this beach up a little bit? Like, do you think that people would be okay in this area doing it? Or is it just a matter of them being so used to this that they wouldn't really mind if it stays the way it is?
I think they'll be, like, so used to it that they wouldn't mind it, yeah.
You too? Yeah. I mean, that was my feeling, too, because I'm from Linden. I'm from a little bit north, so I kind of feel the same way. I feel that people, I mean, they just expect the beach to be like this, but, I mean, would you personally like to see it kind of cleaned up and you could, like, hang out here during the summer and
yeah.
For fishing and stuff? Right, exactly. I mean, do you think that the refinery is a problem in this area, too?
Yeah.
I mean, not like we can move it, but we can probably do something to fix the water up, don't you think?
Yeah,
yeah, right? So any final thoughts on this beach? None? Just exploring today, right?
Yeah.
That sounds good to me. I feel that a lot of people inherently would like to see this beach cleaner, like those two boys said. But it's a matter of how used to it they are, and they're all pretty used to seeing it like this. And that's kind of a sign of what we think of this world right now. That this is just how it is, and that we can't change anything. That mindset that nothing can be changed. So, this project is going to be an ongoing one, just because it's so close to my heart. I'm going to do my best to work with the local community and see what I can do, and my plan is I'm going to keep a YouTube blog, and I'm going to keep updates on it in video updates, and I'm going to see what happens, because I think the main issue with cleanups and other activities like that is that we don't realize that it's not just a one-time thing. This is not a one-time thing. This is a long, slow, steady process that needs to be thought out. We need to be considerate of the people who live here. We need to be considerate of, you know, the companies that make money here, but we also need to be considerate of the land, first and foremost. So, I mean, to that end, this is not something that can be solved in an afternoon. This can't be solved in an afternoon.